to the ends of this world, I'm gonna find you. Is it a blessing or curse? For better or worse, I'm gonna find you.
What's up, everyone? It's Mark from Silence Tech. Today we're going to be putting a bunch of cards through their paces. The main focus will be this Gigabyte GeForce GTX 1660 Ti and how it compares in performance to the GTX 1660 and some other cards for good measure. I've been lucky enough to benchmark all of these cards in the past. Now it's time to give my ultimate opinion on the best overall graphics card you can buy that doesn't cost silly amounts of money. I haven't covered the Gigabyte GTX 1660 Ti on the channel yet, but I've already reviewed the 1660 variant of the exact same model from Gigabyte, so I won't go into any detail about the design or features. Instead, I'll leave a link in the description to my original GTX 1660 review, as they are extremely similar, and today I'll just focus on performance in this comparison. Both have the exact same Turing TU116 GPU inside of them, although the Ti variant has a much faster GDDR6 memory. CUDA cores are up on the Ti as well at 1536 over the non-Ti that has 1408. As for pricing, right now Nvidia's GTX 1660 Ti is priced at $279 US or 270 UK pounds. Last but not least, the 1660 is priced at $220 and 214 UK pounds, and all of these prices are from Amazon as of the 24th of April 2019. So, which one should you pick up? Both of these cards are extremely well priced. I'm especially interested in also seeing how the GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1070 compare, since they're priced pretty much exactly the same right now on Amazon. To get a better idea of the best card to buy out of all of these, let's check out some performance numbers. I've spent far too long doing these benchmarks. Let's jump straight in to see how these cards perform. Well, the best bang for buck out of all of these cards has to be the GTX 1660 Ti and the GTX 1070. The 1660 Ti does slightly lag behind in some games by a few FPS, but it has the potential to give out more performance later on down the road due to the Turing architecture being much newer, and as drivers are released in the future, performance may improve. At this point, the GTX 1070 has had its day. That said, to be honest, you can't actually go wrong with either of these cards. Both are solid choices. The non-Ti GTX 1660 again is an excellent card, and you're not losing too much in the FPS department compared to the Ti or 1070, although you may struggle to hit 60 FPS in some titles even at 1080p with maxed out settings. Battlefield 5, for instance, is a particularly demanding title. Sure, you could just spend more and pick up the Ti version. The bump in performance is well worth the extra, but not everyone can afford it, and you may end up in what I call the PC gaming trap, spending way too much money for what you actually need, and trust me, I know all about that, as you're probably aware of. Ultimately, every card in this video will deliver a great 1080p gaming experience. The 2060 is certainly a card for only 1080p high refresh rate gaming and a bit of 1440 1440p. The 1660 Ti has caused a huge price reduction in mid-range GPUs right now, and it's a great time to build a gaming PC. Amazing how quickly it's all turned around, as only 6 months ago, building a PC was a lot more expensive. Performance is nearly half the price right now. Overall, if I was going to build a completely new, more budget-focused PC paired with a 1080p 60Hz monitor, I would use the 1660 Ti. It's my ultimate choice over every other GPU on the market right now. Of course, it all depends on your budget and needs. I will have a build coming up on this channel very soon using the 1660 Ti based on a Ryzen 2600X system. I'm not sure of the total cost yet, but it's going to make an awesome build. I'll see you real soon, guys. I really hope you've enjoyed this comparison. My name's Mark from Silence Tech. Goodbye.